I'm here with Xavier Martinez, a.k.a. What are you, in England, I went to the Olympics, everybody was asking about you. Where's the Pacquiao hater? Because I found the local Pacquiao hater over there, that he could give you a run for the money.
Nah, he can't give me a run for nothing, because I ain't running for nobody.
Okay, who do you want to see Manny fight next?
Who?
Manny Pacquiao, December 8th. Who do you want to see him fight next?
Dude, give me somebody with a name.
Bradley.
No.
Marquez?
Let's talk about somebody with a name. Let's talk about Andre Ward. Fuck, man.
What? What about, okay, who's on your pop up list right now? Top five.
Top five? Floyd Mayweather. Vladimir Klitschko. I mean, Vitaly Klitschko. Vladimir Klitschko after that. Andre Ward. Marquez.
And Pacquiao?
Bradley.
Pacquiao?
No need to donaire.
You forgot Manny Pacquiao.
I haven't forgot him yet.
I talked to Ring Magazine. They have him as number two. Tied with Floyd. Why, of course?
I mean, because they don't know shit.
Nah, you can't say that. They know boxing. You say the Encyclopedia of Boxing doesn't know boxing?
If they know boxing, he just lost the last fight and had two bad performances before that. What? And he's tied for number two. And why guys like Andre Ward.
Do you really believe he lost the last fight?
I mean, I don't believe, but that's what it is. If you go 10 years from now, then no one's going to get a care.
I say 50, but yeah. You're right. Just like Marquez, no one's going to say he beat Pacquiao.
No, loss is loss, regardless. But, no, I think anywhere from 6 to 10, I couldn't care. If he wasn't even on the top 10, I wouldn't.
Okay, where do you put Sergio Martinez? You haven't mentioned him.
Anywhere from 6 to 10.
Okay, where do you put Abner Morris?
You know, Abner, he's getting up there, and I'd love to see him and Nonito never mix it up. To be honest with you, no one can mess with Abner Mars. I think he would KO Nonito.
Okay, what happens here? He beats Nonito, you think?
I think he KOs it.
Really? He KOs Nonito?
He KOs Nonito.
Why are you so confident about that?
You know, Nonito, he's a strong fighter. Not as quite as technically sound or skilled as Abner Mars.
You don't have anything against fighters from the Philippines, do you?
No, I love Nonito. He's one of my favorite fighters. I just think that he would lose to Abner Mars. And to put Nonito in there with, who's the guy, Jorge Arce? I think he would freaking kill Jorge Arce.
Yeah, he would. I agree with you on that.
Ridiculous.
How about Gamboa or Rigondeaux? Sorry, Rigondeaux, that's more.
I mean, Rigondeaux still only got 9 fights, you know what I mean? Even though he's a world champ. I don't know how he beat Rico Ramos, but whatever. If he's a world champ, he should be ready to fight anybody. But I still don't think that he could beat those guys.
Xavier, what fights are you watching this weekend?
Chavez Jr. and Sergio Martinez.
You gonna buy the pay-per-view?
Yeah.
What about Canelo? What about Canelo?
I have a TV in my yard, my TV in the house. I got already all the tiki torches ready. House is ready.
What about Marcos Maidana fight against Soto Carr? You're not gonna watch any
great
of that?
Great fight, man.
Are you gonna watch those?
I don't know. I'm gonna be between the yard and inside the house. Be watching.
One TV's gonna. Which card is gonna be in the house and which card is in the backyard?
I'm probably gonna have the Chavez fight inside and Canelo outside.
Who wins that fight?
Which one?
Chavez Jr. against Sergio Martinez.
Chavez Jr.
You think so?
I think so. Yeah.
Why?
I think. See, you know, everybody's talking about how Sergio Martinez moves his head and moves around with his hands down, strong punches. What about Kelly Pavlik? What about Paul Williams?
Yep.
They're great fighters, but none of them.
Chavez Jr. is better than Paul Williams and better than Kelly Pavlik?
Yes, more technically sound. Here's the reason why. None of those guys went to Sergio Martinez's body. Chavez Jr. is gonna tattoo that guy's body.
Tattoo? What is he gonna tattoo? A picture of Pacquiao?
Yeah, he's gonna tattoo a picture of Pacquiao and then knock it out. See, the thing about guys like Sergio Martinez, he moves his head and everything. The head moves, but the body stays in the same place.
I'm gonna need a security check on something you just said. Security check. Chavez Jr. is more technically sound than Kelly Pavlik or who's the other guy we
know?
Or Paul Williams.
I'll let the comment slingers handle that one. How did it even go there?
There's no way he's more sound than Paul Williams. Paul Williams is more polished.
How about this? Josecito Lopez Canelo, break it down.
Lopez is gonna knock him out.
Knock him out? Josecito Lopez is gonna knock out Canelo?
Yeah, I'm pulling for him.
Why?
All right, I gotta say, there's no reason why.
No, he's a good dude. Does he have the...
I'm pulling for Francisco Lopez. I think he's gonna knock Canelo out. I have no reason why. I'm just saying it just because that's my feeling.
Coach Dion, how many people do you think he pissed off in this video right now?
What was the video on?
Manny Pacquiao is number 6 to 10 pound for pound. Nonito Donaire gets knocked out by Abner Mares. What else did you say? Chavez Jr. is more technically sound than Kelly Pavlik or Paul Williams. And Josito Lopez knocks out Canelo. Knocks out.
Yeah, he gonna piss off a lot of people, and a lot of people gonna say, just gonna look at him and say, that's just some of the stupidest picks ever, but, you know, that's boxing.
Chavez Jr., more sound than those two fighters?
No, I'll say that one, with that one, I can somewhat see that, you know what I mean?
What is Paul Williams and Kelly Pavlik both favorite things? They're headhunters. Chavez Jr. is gonna go after that body.
As far as fundamentals,
but they pay their dues. They didn't have 48 fights in a row where they were handed. They fought people.
Yeah, even with that, still, whether they had that or not, as far as fundamentals, I can somewhat agree with saying that he's more fundamentally sound. He getting his ass whooped this weekend, but he's maybe more fundamentally sound.
What do you say about that? He said Chavez Jr.
is boxing. I mean, you're gonna have people who are gonna agree, disagree, but I really think that Chavez Jr. is gonna pull it off. I think he may stop him between the 8th and 11th round.
It could happen. I don't see it, but it could happen. I've seen crazier things happen.
You know, and a lot of the guys like Paul Williams and Kelly Pavlik, the pressure fighters, but they're not guys like Chavez Jr. who's in your chest the whole entire time. They're in your chest no matter what you want.
And I think what he's saying is Paul Williams and Kelly Pavlik don't have as many tools. They don't have as many tools as Chavez Jr. has. You know what I mean?
I would have to highly disagree, Coach.
What they got? Paul Williams had his height and speed. Kelly Pavlik had a right hand.
Three-time champion, Paul Williams.
Yeah, but regardless of that, as far as just a fundamental fighter, they didn't have all the tools.
Okay.
There's more stuff
Chavez Jr. fought Sebastian Zivic for the title. They fought people that Sebastian Zivic would not be allowed to hold their bag to let them in the gym.
But you're still missing the point. Is regardless of that, what we're talking about is what they can do overall. Like, I put it to you like this.
Okay, if you take...
Hold on. You got Shaquille O'Neal, okay? One of the most unstoppable forces in the history of the game, okay?
True.
But he can't do the same things that Kareem could do.
Okay.
You know what I mean? That's the difference I'm trying to make, is that what Kareem...
He destroys Kareem.
He
manhandles Kareem.
Yeah, because he's stronger. But as far as like technique and a lot of different things you can do, that's the difference between Chavez and like saying Kelly Pavlik and Paul Williams. Not taking anything away from those guys, but they can't do overall.
Okay. Last fight I'm gonna ask you about, Miguel Cotto against Austin Trout.
Great fight. I think it's an awesome fight.
I say Austin Trout wins.
Maybe. It'd be a great fight, but let me give you a good analogy. That's a great analogy. Let me give you a better one. If you took Paul Williams' height away, and took Kelly Pavlik's power away, would they be as great as they are? If you put Chavez Jr. smaller, taller, he's always going to be good. He's a good fighter.